Namaste, dear friends. Today we are going to see how to calculate design bending strength of a laterally supported beam. This topic is related with the design of steel structures using IS 800-2007, that is Indian Standard Code. So the following problem or the example which we have adopted here is from Limit State Design of Steel Structures, authored by S.K. Duggal, purely for illustrating the design process to the students during COVID-19 lockdown. So our problem statement is to determine the design bending strength of ISLB 350 at 486 Newton per meter, considering the beam to be laterally supported. Second part is laterally unsupported. Here the design shear force V is less than the design shear strength that already they have given here. The unsupported length of the beam is 3 meters and they are asked to use Fe410. Now, as per given data and the standards or specifications from IS 800-2007, gamma M0 is 1.1, alpha LT, that is the imperfection factor for rolled section, that is 0.21, clause number 8.2.2, page number 54. So as the section is given, we need to write first its properties. Here, as section is given as ISLB 350. So for ISLB 350 at 486 Newton per meter, the depth of flange H equals to 350 mm. Width of flange BF is equal to 165 mm. Thickness of flange TF equals to 11.4 mm. Thickness of web TW is equal to 7.4 mm. Radius at root R1 is equal to 16 mm. IYY equals to 631.9 into 10 to the power 4 mm to the power 4. Then again, plastic section modulus ZPZ is equal to 851.11 into 10 to the power 3. mm to the power 3. Then here elastic section modulus is given as ZEZ 751.9 into 10 to the power 3 mm to the power 3. Radius of gyration for the given section will be RYY, and which is equal to 31.7. When we are interested to calculate actual depth of web, then the formula is, which is written over here, D is equal to H minus 2 into in bracket TF plus R1. D is equal to 350 minus 2 into 11.4 plus 16, and that depth will be 295.2 mm. This all parameters we'll see actually in diagram. So our next step is to classify the section. Is the section is plastic, compact or semi-compact. So here in IS 800-2007, table number 2, limiting width to thickness ratio, the clause number 3.7.2 and 3.7.4, they have mentioned here for the outstanding element of the compression flange for the rolled section. So in case of I section, the top flange is a compression flange, and the length of flange which is available after the web, after the web, that is called as a outstanding element. So when we want to take here BF by TF, we need to consider that half of the length of the flange. So here BF by TF ratio we need to take first, and then another one parameter we need to check here, that is a neutral axis at mid depth, D by TW ratio, and that again mention over here for the different classes of the section. So we'll see in the next diagram from where and how it is calculated. Now this is a pure section which is given over here. In this cross section area, the top flange here, the top flange, this top flange is nothing but a compression flange, and the bottom flange is a tension flange. In this cross section, we can see that the total depth of the cross section is a 350 mm, and the width of flange is 165 mm. So when we want to consider the actual depth of web, so here the total depth is 350, and the effective depth that we need to calculate by subtracting the thickness of flanges, both flanges, top and bottom flange, and again this R radius at curve. So here, after reducing that, we'll get 295.2. That will be the depth, effective depth of the flange. So first ratio is B is equal to BF by 2. So width of flange divided by 2, that is 165 divided by 2, that is 82.5 mm. Here again, epsilon, value of epsilon by that which we are considering for FE410. So for FE410, FY is a 250, so under root 250 divided by FY, so the value will be 1. So we are calculating here ratio B by TF is equal to this ratio, and the value which we are getting is 7.23, which is less than 9.4 epsilon, and D by TW ratio here 295.2 divided by 7.4, which is 39.4, which is less than 84 epsilon. So if we will check again in IS 800 2007, then after considering that ratio, we are getting BF by TF ratio less than 9.4 epsilon. It means section is plastic, and again D by TW ratio is less than TW ratio, less than 84 epsilon. So again here we can consider that the our section that which we are going to calculate strength for the same is a plastic section, and as the section is plastic, then the value of beta B we can take it as a 1. So here, as the ratio D by TW is 39.9, which is less than again 67 epsilon, so in such cases shear buckling check of the web is not required. So directly we can calculate here strength of the laterally supported beam. So the standard formula as mentioned in clause number 8.2.1.2, page number 53 of IS 800 2007, MD is equal to beta B ZPZ FY divided by gamma M0. So for plastic section again beta B is equal to 1. So after keeping all the values in the formula, MD is equal to 1. 851.11 into 10 to the power 3, 250 divided by 1.1 into 10 to the power minus 6. So the value which we are getting for the MD is a 193.43 kilonewton meter. So here, when we are calculating value of design capacity for the laterally supported beam, we need to check that the MD must be less than 1.2 ZEFY divided by gamma M0. Value of MD which we are getting for the elastic section modulus ZE 1.2 into ZE into FY divided by gamma M0. So MD is equal to 1.2 into 751.9, that's the value of ZEZ, and that value is now which we are getting is a 205 kilonewton meter. So again, when we check it, the value is less than 193.43. So it is okay. So therefore, for given section, that is the given section was here ISLB 350. For ISLB 350, when the length of beam is 3 meters, then its maximum capacity to take loading as 193 kilonewton meter, that is a design bending capacity. So in next problem we'll see how to calculate design strength of laterally unsupported beam. Thank you. For more detail, subscribe to my channel and press bell icon to stay updated. Thank you.